attorney Ann Hansen. I'm an extension plant pathologist with Virginia Cooperative Extension, and we're out here on the Virginia Tech campus today on the 25th of September, 2017, to talk about powdery mildew diseases. And powdery mildew diseases are common on a lot of different plants. A lot of people are familiar with this disease because it shows up as a white powdery substance or growth on the leaf surface. And there are a number of different species of powdery mildew fungi. These fungi are favored by warm days, cool nights, and high humidity, which we have plenty of at this time of year. There are many different species of powdery mildew fungi, and they each specialize on certain host plants. So the powdery mildew that you see on your cucumber, for example, is not the same one that occurs on this dogwood that we're looking at today. And the dogwood powdery mildew is interesting and a little different because you often don't see the typical symptoms of powdery mildew that most people recognize. So if we look closely at these leaves today, we see a lot of blotchy reddening of the leaves. The leaves are senescing early, they're turning color early, and it just looks like the tree's been under a fair amount of stress. And you don't really see that white powdery growth very obvious on the leaf surface. But this disease on this dogwood is powdery mildew. And on dogwoods, it may take magnification to see those fine white strands of the fungal mycelium on the leaf surface, but they are there. And the fungus is causing this early leaf senescence. And it can actually do more damage than it may appear from the lack of the white growth on the leaf surface. It's been shown by research that if the tree is attacked year after year, it can actually be significantly stunted. The best way to control powdery mildew is to choose a resistant cultivar in the first place when you're planting dogwoods. And there are several cultivars of Cornus florida, the native flowering dogwood, that have been bred for resistance to this disease. The University of Tennessee breeders have come up with several different cultivars, including Jean's Appalachian Snow and Karen's Appalachian Blush and Kay's Appalachian Mist, all named after the breeders' wives. Cherokee Brave is another cultivar that's pink flower that has resistance. And most of the Chinese dogwoods, Cornus cusa, have resistance to powdery mildew. So if you don't want your trees looking kind of ugly in mid to late summer and turning red early, then choose one of those resistant cultivars for a new planting. You can also control the disease with fungicides, but you need to start spraying as the buds begin to open and continue on a regular interval as specified on the label. And of course, raking up the leaves under the tree at the end of the season will help to prevent overwintering of the fungus as well.